people here in the Lower West Side, a lot of the people in the community are coming together to demonstrate what would happen to us if a mass emergency happened, or if a lot of people had series of accidents or illness. Where would people go? We're asking the question. Within a matter of days, community board is going to approve the upzoning of this hospital so that it can become luxury condominium. And we're here to demand that this hospital be remained intact, that the zoning remains intact, so that we can attract another hospital company or other investors to open a hospital right here on this site.
What would you say to people who say that there's a comprehensive care center that's going to be part of this new package along with the condos? So what is the community all up in arms about?
That new care center that will be opened up across the street is a very misleading institution. It won't treat heart attacks. It cannot treat women who are pregnant. It cannot perform complex operations. In fact, I went to a meeting where the chief of the EMS for New York City said the complicated health emergency taken to this care facility because it won't be equipped or staffed with enough specialists who will be qualified to treat trauma patients. So that facility
we need a hospital
will treat people
this woman is
who are
really
facing
sick.
Life and death emergencies.
She's bleeding!
Our government should be providing better for its citizens. We all pay taxes. We pay a lot of taxes. And we demand that there be a healthcare system that exists that provides services and treatment.
Do you think there could be a line drawn from corporate greed or landlords or controversial terms to closing this hospital?
I would say yes, because everyone in city government, the top politicians, beginning with Christine Quinn, who is Speaker of the City Council, to the mayor, they were elected to a third term. And here we have a situation where a billionaire real estate developer, William Rudin, stands to sell condominiums once they are developed that will be worth over $1 billion. And I think that the city politicians are putting the profit that is being generated, or that Mr. William Rudin sees that he can make from this building, they're putting that ahead of public health and public safety. So yes, I do see that there is some kind of connection here, and I think it's a travesty, and that's why you see the community out here gathered with so much passion that we're here to try to save this hospital.